Vicki Fitch here, your direct sales expert and the host of Vicki Fitch Live, A Fresh Perspective. I know you guys have watched the graphics. I know you've been anticipating my guest for tonight, but I'm super excited about bringing on my friend, Mr. Ross Brand. He is a previous radio show broadcaster. He also has live stream media, or live stream universe. He's got content galore. He is an expert in the field, the go-to guy, basically the one all of us go to when we have questions about live streaming. So I want to introduce you to my friend, Mr. Ross Brand. Ross, how are you?
Hey, Vicki. Thanks so much for having me on.
I can't believe we haven't really talked
on air before this.
Right?
I mean, we've known each other going all the way back to the heyday of Blab when things were good. Those couple of weeks where Blab was really rolling, and you know, it's taken quite a while, but I'm so honored to be on your show and looking forward to chatting with you about live streaming, Summit Live, and everything else going on in the world of online broadcasting.
Oh my gosh. I know. I feel like it truly has been forever. Like, we've been trying to get you on the show and me on your show and things. And it's like, but I feel like we know each other so well, even though we've actually not really had, like you said, much conversation, or we just know each other. And it's kind of a cool thing that the online, you know, our live streaming universe brings to us, right? Is that we develop relationships because we actually do get to see, hear each other and kind of converse without having, you know, we don't have to have that in-person touch, although I absolutely adore it, right? But we don't have to have it. We can still develop a relationship, which is one of the cool things about live streaming.
It's kind of the closest thing to meeting somebody in person, is to experience being in the same live stream with them and seeing how they interact. And it takes it to a whole nother level from following somebody's social posts that are images or text or whatever. You really get to learn and get to know people. And I mean, I think also, I've been following your shows because we've been featuring you in the live stream updates along the way, and you have like great guest after great guest each week. So it's been fun to follow, you know, your show and see the development.
Oh, thank you so much. And I see we have some awesome guests here. We have Mr. Dave Gonzalez, Alfredo's in the house.
Alfredo.
Guys, totally appreciate you guys being here. And do us a favor and click that share button. Click the share button, because you want people to come in here and we want to hear you interact with you guys. We want to see what you have to say. Do you know Alfredo? Are you guys buds?
I know Alfredo. Alfredo's great. Alfredo is always keeping the chat going. I love that.
Well, Alfredo, we have to become much more acquainted, my friend. I like people who get in the chat box and get things going. That makes things amazing. And again, thank you guys for sharing this out. And I forgot last week, so I have got to just like cover my bases here. If you guys do not know the audiovisual team here at Enlightened Audiovisual, behind the scenes, they are the bomb.com. I got Mr. Rob Hicks in the house. I got Mr. Sam Gonzalez in the house. And do they not do a stellar job, Ross? We are the profesh peeps over here, right?
It looks so great, and they got us set up in like under a half an hour, and it's rolling, and it's always fun to work with these guys.
I know, they're amazing. I love them. Like I said, I feel like one of the luckiest girls on the planet. Not only do I get these rocking great guests just like you, but I have this great team. And again, we get to bring live streaming to a whole new level. So, you know, Ross, one of the things that we like to do is kind of just have a question of the day. And so I want to know a little bit about you, because, you know, if you've watched the show, you know, Vicki Fitch Live is not, it's a fresh perspective. It's not the same stuff everybody else always asks you. So, you know,
I'm kind of good at answering the same stuff over and over again.
I know.
You're going to make it difficult on me.
Not difficult. You're going to make it interesting, right?
Bring it on.
We start easy. We go easy, right? We'll kind of ease you into it. So just tell me, first of all, where you grew up, and then I'll throw a question on top. So like, I'll give you the little ease in.
Okay. I grew up in New Jersey, which is where I live now, although I've lived a bunch of different places. But I grew up in New Jersey from when I was like 6 months old to through high school. And then, you know, went away to college, came back, lived in New Jersey for a year and a half. And then I've lived all over. And now I'm, you know, the last, I don't know, almost decade, I guess, I've been back in New Jersey.
Okay. So, all right. So then tell me about, so I see Miss Jenny Quinn in the house and she's saying, don't get Fitch slapped. Right? Like she's preparing you for the Fitch slap.
Ooh, right? You know, I move my hands a lot when right. I talk, so it's not going to be easy to get through there.
Right.
You're going to have to get me while you're talking.
Well, you know what? Are you Italian? Do you got some Italian? Oh, you see, that's my mama always used to say it's the Italian in us. That's why we talk with our hands. Oh my goodness.
But I think if you grow up in New Jersey, you pick up on some of that anyway, but right?
Some of those things that you hand motion in New Jersey, I don't know that we want to use it on the show.
Okay.
Okay. So
that's how we just say hello to each other, but we won't do it that way.
Yeah, let's not. We'll keep the Jersey hellos to the side on the side. And Miss Melanie Weiser in the house. Mel, thanks for being here. And guys, thanks so much for sharing it out. Again, we really appreciate you. All right. So here's your other question. Are you ready?
I am ready.
All right. I want you to share one embarrassing moment in your life. One. I don't care if it's when you're little or when you're older. We won't pick. Just pick a, give us an embarrassing moment.
One always comes up. That the first like thing that comes up is when I was working in radio fairly early on, right? I would go into the studio with the host to do the sports cast. Uh-huh. And I would do the sports cast and then he would turn the mic off and then we would just chat about anything, right? And so it was like the Uh-oh. Two of us were kind of different.
Uh-oh, I'm cringing.
Right. So I did my sports cast like always. He turned the mic off. I was upset about something. And I said, so-and-so is a bleep, 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 bleep. And he goes, he waits. He goes, I forgot to turn the mic off. And I went like bright red and hit the table and like couldn't breathe. And he's like, oh, no, I'm just kidding.
Oh, you're kidding. Oh, my gosh. Okay. Well, that
I was like, don't ever do that again. But right? But lesson learned.
Yeah.
Leave a little space before you.
Oh.
And I'm not saying like I get off a show and I start.
Right.
But it was a unique circumstance. But we always just talked and joked around and everything. And okay. This one time I figured, I could just say what I want. You know, it's just the two of us in here. Right.
Right. Letting off a little steam, being a little silly. And Jen Nelson's in the house, too. Jen, thanks for being here. Melanie says she's only half Italian, so she only uses one hand. That's good, Mel. That is so good. I love it. But thank you for sharing that with us, Ross, because I believe that, you know, live streaming is something too that as we start to do it, that people get to know us. I think that know, like, and trust factor gets really built up where people go, okay, you know what? He's real. Okay. So yeah, he's not perfect. He actually once in a while lets off a little steam, and, right. You know, it could be an embarrassing moment. So we're not perfect, right? Just because we're live streamers, we are not perfect at all.
No, not at all. And you know, one of the things that, you know, live streaming is so comfortable because we all feel like we're friends and we know each other. Sure. And that is something to keep in mind for people who are building their brand or building their business through live streaming is that sometimes we can get caught up in how casual it is and forget yeah. that this is public and people are listening. So, mm-hmm. I mean, I learned the lesson in a harsh way early on, but I never made that, you know, I try and have fun and, you know, be myself, but I also kind of know, you got to kind of know where the line is too, because it's, right. this is public and, you know, you still need to conduct yourself in a way that's professional and that represents your brand and your business and the people that you're doing business with and all that in a very professional way. So it's a fun mix, right? It's social and it's a little bit of tech that, yeah. you know, maybe we didn't get into in our other parts of our life. And that's why it's great that you have Rob here and other people that can, you know, help out with that area. And it's also a little bit of broadcasting. So you bring those three areas together, tech, broadcasting and social, and it's unique. It's not the same as doing TV. It's not the same as doing social media. And it's not enough to just be a tech guy. You got to bring it all together.
Yeah. And it's a blending, right? And it's the people that really blend it together well, like you do, that become the rock stars in the industry that people are like, yeah, that's, I want to be like that. I want to step up my game. I'm watching Ross Brand. I love the way he does this, delivers these messages. I'm watching, you know, Jenny Q's show. I'm watching these people and saying, gosh, you know what? I really like, I like what they're doing. I like where they're going with it. And so, you know, again, kudos to you on that front, which we are going to talk, we're going to dive into it a little bit more, but we also know that community is a really big part. And that's why you have developed a really cool community, which we'll talk about in a minute. But you know that I have a group called the Entrepreneurial Rockstars. And each week we have a rock star of the week that we bring on. Well, I have something special today, you guys. I have to let you know that many of you know that I did a live broadcast, or not a live broadcast, a sales training at the Girl Scouts not too long ago. And so, and yeah, by the way, Rob, thanks for putting that up, Rob. If you guys want to be part of a community and part of a group, the Rockstars, you can go to VickiFitch.com/freebies and join us in the Entrepreneurial Rockstars. We want to help you to be the best you you can be. We are a supportive group that wants to give at least as much as we get. So to this week's rock star is a little bit different. It's somebody who's just now building their entrepreneurial skills. I went out and helped the Girl Scouts to figure out how to sell more cookies. And so today I am really lucky. I have my niece, Chloe, who's going to join us. So Chloe is a Girl Scout from Troop. I forgot the troop number really quick, but we will get it in a second. So I think Rob is going to put you on screen in a second, and we will. Here we go, Miss Chloe. This is my adorable niece, Chloe, which I call her JoJo, just so you guys know. That's a story for another day. But hi, JoJo. How are you?
Hey, I'm Vicki. My troop number is 6064.
See, look at her. She's on it. She's like, I'm delivering value. I have a good smile on my face. I got my Girl Scout uniform, so I got my branding going. I'm ready to rock and roll. So, Chloe, tell everybody a little bit about the Girl Scouts, about what it's about, and what are you guys doing at this time of year?
Okay, so the Girl Scouts, so we're kind of like we're a big organization, and sometimes what we do is we go to with the money sometimes that we raise from like nut sales and cookie sales, that we go to the Ronald McDonald House and we help. We cook for them and we help them and have a better meal. And right now we're actually selling cookies.
Yes, you are selling cookies. And we actually, when I did some sales training with you and your troop, right, we came up with some sales goals and we came up with a hashtag. Do you remember what our hashtag is?
It was hashtag GS Cookie Fix.
That's right. So we want to help you guys to get your GS cookie fix on right now. Now, and because there's an opportunity for you guys, and we know that it's a little difficult. We have an audience all over the world, and we thank you guys so much for being here. Even those of you who are listening on the podcast, if you've downloaded this from iTunes or Stitcher, wherever you are either watching or just listening to the podcast, we want to give you an opportunity not only to help Chloe's troop, but we want to help our troops. And Chloe, you can tell them you guys have a promotion. And then it's about the troops. And yeah, it's 6064. You can send cookies to the troops. Now, Rob has it up on the screen there. If you guys take a screenshot of it, you guys can make the checkout to Troop 6064. Whatever you send, they will send cookies to the troops. And you can see a picture there of the troops. Again, those of you who are listening, I hope you guys will check out episode 29 with Mr. Ross Brandon, my guest at Vicki Fitch Live. You can go to VickiFitch.com and the Vicki Fitch Live page. You can also go to YouTube. There's lots of places you can see these great pictures and see how adorable my niece is, just so you know. But you guys, if you want to help the troop and you want to help that adorable little niece of mine, you guys can write checks out to Troop 6064, send it to the address on the screen, which we will put in the show notes. And for every $5, they will send a box of cookies to the troops. And I think we all agree, no matter what your political point of view is, that we want to make sure that our troops are supported and they feel they are recognized as people that are special to us. What do you think about that, Chloe?
That's pretty good. Yeah, I think that's amazing.
And you know, your grandparents served in the military, so it's really important for us to keep their spirits up, right? What else do you mm-hmm. want to share with them about the Girl Scouts or about yourself, Chloe?
Sometimes in Girl Scouts, we like do a lot of stuff. Like we kind of mostly have been helping the Ronald McDonald House. We've mostly been like going there and we've been cooking for them, or we've been to like people who need, you know, like we adopted actually a child, our troop, we adopted a kid. And so every Christmas we find out what he wants and we actually give it to him. We like get him, he wanted like Laker pajama pants and we got him those, and he just went crazy happy for them. And he can't come out because he's in the hospital, but he just got, he was really happy that we bought all those gifts for him. And so we kind of just do like nonprofit things with the money sometimes that we get from our cookie sales, or sometimes we sell nuts to get like, well, money to do stuff like that.
Well, you know, Chloe, and if you guys want, you need to put on the bottom of the check, then it's, that's called Gift of Caring is what we're doing for the troops. But if you guys want to donate money to this, the child that they adopted, you can also put that at the bottom of the check so they can buy some extra Christmas gifts. And Chloe, I will make a donation and make sure that I get that to you with this, so you can support both of those things. Plus, I have to buy some extra cookies, you know, because I already know, like, you know, I guess that's, it's my civic duty. So, I mean, I really can't, you know, I could just make excuses, but I won't. Anyway, Chloe, we really appreciate you having you on here, honey. Is there anything else that you want to say to the guests?
Thank you for watching.
You're adorable, Chloe. Chloe, I really appreciate you being here, sweetheart. I appreciate being able to talk to your troop, and I hope that you guys can rock that dream with those cookie sales. Remember, guys, get your GS cookie fix here. Use the hashtag and tweet it out. And maybe if somebody takes a screenshot of this, you guys can tweet that out as well to @GirlScouts, and then use the hashtag GS cookie fix and tag me in it @Vicki_Fitch. So, and Chloe, you can go ahead and sign out, baby. You don't have to stay in the back room, but I appreciate you coming here. And so, you guys, you understand, like, now we've got Mr. Ross Brand here. He's coming back to give you guys the goods. And we're going to start digging around in his life a little bit. We're going to dig around in his tips. So, Ross, come on back in here.
Hello. Well, that's a tough act to follow.
Isn't it? She's pretty cute, isn't she?
Very cute, doing good work, doing good things in the community. And speak about a rock star. Look at that setup she's got. Multiple keyboards on the wall. Yeah, and I look at my background here. I'm thinking, well, she should be the headliner. I should be going on for a segment.
See, that's another great quality of a live streamer. One that is able to give credit to others and pass off some of the stardom. Because I have to say, Ross, that's one of the things that I really adore about you, is not only do you do your own show, but you are one of the one that collects all the data from the rest of us about what our shows are. And you deliver a broadcast. It used to be recorded, but now you're doing them live, that tells everybody what shows are going on for the day and the week, so people can start to really connect with that audience. And that, I mean, that is just something coming out of the giving of your heart and an opportunity to serve the community. So tell us a little bit about, why is it that community is important to you, and why did you start this? What made you say, yeah, I'm going to go, you know, I'm going to dig in and support everybody, not just myself.
When I found Blab, first of all, I fell in love with Blab instantly. I had gotten out of radio about 10 years ago, before I, 9, 10, 8, 9, 10, whatever it was, before I found Blab, right? And I figured I'd never do anything with broadcasting again, not because I didn't like it, just because I had other interests and whatever. And I thought Blab was some sort of chat room thing when people were going to chat about Blab. I'm like, I'm not going to go in there, you know, whatever. Who knows what goes on in there?
Right.
One day, I think I saw somebody put some note about Blab or whatever. And I said, okay, I'll check this out. And I was like, wow, I stumbled and fell into like talk radio heaven with webcams, except right. It's all people that were so relatable, you know, who were just talking about their lives and their businesses and things like that. And I was surprised that like it was really, there was some really good stuff on there. Of course, we know there was some nonsense on there too, but there were some people who were really, really talented on there. And to me, I just thought, okay, there's no way to know what's going on though, right? I mean, yes, they had a little bit of discovery back in the beginning before they killed that off in one of their many brilliant business moves. But there was no way, even with that discovery, to really know what was coming up. And there were not only people who I felt were worthy of having their shows reach a bigger audience, but there are also people who are primarily content consumers and just enjoyed the experience. I didn't even think I would get on a mic or turn on a webcam or anything. I just was enjoying you know, watching it. So I wanted to share it with people. And that's how I started. And I started by posting stuff on Instagram and Twitter. And I started a website. And, you know, that got a little bit of, you know, a little bit of interaction with people. And I got to know people. But it really took off when I started doing it in video form. And why not, right? If you're going to talk about live video, why not do it in video form? And you mentioned that I had been doing it pre-recorded, which allowed me to really make sure that I keep it tight in a certain, you know, not go more than 5 minutes. And I could add a couple of bells and whistles and a music bed. And if there was a mistake, I could cut that out, or I could retake if I got off on a tangent or I went too long, whatever. But all of a sudden the time that it took to record multiple times and edit and do production and all that. And I found like the last few days, I guess starting like Thursday of last week, I just didn't have that time. And if I did that, then it wouldn't get done before the shows were on. So I went ahead and did it live. And I was like, well, this is kind of fun. I can talk to people beforehand and then deliver it. And it's a challenge. So it kind of makes you grow a little bit, because doing that much live, right, is a different story than just, you know, going on where you have a planned show and you have an idea. So I kind of find it fun. And today I realized I saved so much time by doing it live that I actually went live using Wirecast onto YouTube for the first time ever. So awesome. I did two live updates today, one on Facebook and one on YouTube. So that's kind of my thing, is to just keep pushing the boundaries a little bit in 2017, doing more mobile video and also doing more things live that maybe I would have said, okay, this is really really kind of a format that should be pre-recorded, but sure, there's just a fun aspect of doing it live. And frankly, we all need to save some time where we can. Right.
Right. I totally agree. And you know, first of all, Leslie is in the house. Q, the brand, is in the house, and Mr. Hey. Chris Barrows actually has a question for you. So before we miss that, I wanted to ask you that and then kind of piggyback on some of the things. And really quick, Nikki, my assistant, when she transcribes this, Nikki, the quote, talk radio heaven with cameras. that was gold. So Nikki definitely used that. And so Chris wants to know, so glad you did start. Wait, you're the best. Oh no, I don't see. That's not a question. I thought there was a question there. You're the best source in all things live streaming. Maybe I'm missing it, but if there was another question, if somebody can make sure we get that, that would be super cool. Let's see. And but Ross, you have, you know, you like you said, when they went on when Blab came out, okay, let's face it, like, you know, that was a huge start. Many of us had already been on Periscope and started the live streaming, you know, kind of dove into live streaming. And then, you know, then all of a sudden Blab was on the scene, and basically all of us went from Periscope, not that we left Periscope, but we all jumped into the Blabosphere, is what we called it, right? And we connected in a community that we are still here. It is, it's been gone for, you know, not quite a year, maybe 9 months. And we're all still friends and looking, you know, we're going to, you know, Summit Live, which we're going to talk about in a little bit. And we are, you know, having each other as guests on podcasts and creating content that people want to consume. Cause like you said, now he said Red Set and Vicki Fitch Live when we were still on Blab. But we know that there was some content of some, you know, people that would do questionable things. Let's just say to say the least, or idiotic things, like, you know, just idiotic things. We'll just leave it at that. And
we got the idea.
Yeah, just leave it at that. And then there were people like you that were coming on. We were creating value with, you know, with conversation with other people. And sometimes it would even get heated. You know, it would even, you know, there would be some debates going on. And I won't say everybody did it with respect, but I know that when we, you know, when we would contribute to things, we would do it with dignity and respect, whether we agreed or disagreed. So I'd love for you to comment on that and tell me if there's been a time in your broadcasting history that you kind of threw down the gauntlet that you were not going to take, you know, somebody's bologna sandwiches anymore.
Well, I did shows that were call-in shows in radio. And so I did have somebody who was stalking me, so I kind of had to not allow her to call in anymore.
That's ugly, right?
A little bit scary.
Yeah.
But it was also sort of cool because it's like, oh, somebody's watching. Okay.
I have arrived.
It's like I've arrived. I've got a stalker. Yay. But actually, it's quite unnerving. So, yeah, that was where I had a, you know, but in terms of like somebody comes on with a different opinion, as long as they keep it clean and don't get us in trouble with the FCC back in the radio,
right,
radio era. I was totally fine with people coming from whatever their view is. And I think you just have to stay in control because it's your broadcast. It's your show. And one of the things that I sometimes have trouble with, because I want to give everybody a voice and give everybody a platform, is you have to remember that you're there to serve all your audience, right, not just the one person. So sometimes you have to move along if it's not helping.
Right.
The rest of the audience enjoy the experience, right? Or stay committed to what's going on. So that's not easy for me. I want to, you know, make everybody feel included and feel good. And there were certainly times on Blab where I was like 99% sure the person was a troll. And right, I took a guess on the 1% and I never, you know, was never right. They were always a troll. What looked like a troll? What's a troll? I even like, you know, the troll would come on. They wouldn't say anything. And I'd go, okay, maybe they're having trouble with their mic. And so I let them back in again. That was always a brilliant decision. So right, you learn as you go along, right? I mean, you don't have a call screener like we did in radio, which was like one layer of,
right,
of being crazy out of the equation, right?
So trying to whip the crazy out. And I see Shelton Baumgartner is in the house, and Johnny Popboss is here. He was talking about the Skrelly type things, because if you right, were on the Blabosphere, you know that is what I honestly believe that was the beginning of the end of Blab. And I mean, they were looking at places to bring content in, but that they were bringing in, and again, Martin, if you're watching this, that was what you did was awful. It was awful. It was rude. It was disrespectful, dissing people, trying to create this weird dissension that I've never experienced before. You know, bring people in, antagonize them, throw them out of your room, and then pull them back in. It was like mocking kids, even though some of these were adults. It was horrendous. But there were, you know, people like us. Like I stood up for, you know, people in there. I know that you would have, even when it's uncomfortable. Like you said, we have to move along a broadcast, but sometimes we also have to take a stand. And, right, you know, and I think you've taken a stand in the live streaming world and the live streaming community, saying, you know, Ross Brand stands for everyone. He stands for the live stream universe. It is not just about you. It's not just about, you know, your content, but that you are, you know, you're giving a voice to other people and you're helping them, you know, to find their voice in this, you know, new, what we called the Blabosphere, right? Which is new stratosphere of live streaming. You know, what would you say one of your most difficult experiences has been
with live streaming? Mm-hmm. I don't know. It's been such a fun ride. I mean, it's hard for me to pin. I think the whole thing, and you kind of touched on it. I mean, the whole thing with Blab, Not so much the fact that they made a business decision to pivot and go in a different direction. They have every right to serve the interests of their employees and their investors and all that. They have every right to do that. But the way that they went about doing it, not only because it was rude, it was offensive. I felt like they grew to hate the community that really rallied around them, and that maybe we give Blab as in Team Blab or as in the platform itself more credit than it probably deserves. I mean, I think they lucked into putting things in the right place that enabled us to come together and everything. But I think it's shameful if you know your platform isn't working right or you've made some changes and you know people have shows and people have committed. Yes, it was free. Yes, it was in beta. But that doesn't, free doesn't mean it has to be unprofessional, right? And how you deal with people and all that, because we were supplying the content for Blab, and without our content, there's no platform to grow. There's nothing for them to test. There's nothing for them to understand how it would go to the next stage. There's nothing to show for investors and whatever. So while, you know, we may not complain, be able to raise issues like with the way we would if we were paying a monthly fee, sure, which, you know, many of us would have been happy to.
Totally.
I just didn't like the fact that, you know, they knew that it wasn't going to work one night, but who cares, right? It's just a bunch of people having shows, you know. Right. Nevertheless, maybe you had an author on, or you had somebody who was new to the platform, and they had to go through that embarrassing front page, and, you know, or the platform didn't work, or they introduced a bunch of new features at the last minute just to test them out and see.
Right.
So I thought the whole way they approached the community, and they didn't tell the truth. And I don't want to relitigate the whole blab thing. We kind of know. But you asked me the question. That was the most frustrating thing, was dealing with, we knew blab was not going in a direction we wanted it to. We knew the team didn't like us. Some people were denying that that was the case. Some people were defending Team Blab. There were people who were ripping Team Blab, and then somebody from Team Blab would come into the room, and I might actually say to them what's going on. They'd be like, whoa, you can't do it. I'd be like, well, actually, I don't think it's so bad to actually say what's bothering you to the person's face, rather than hold these chat sessions behind their back. And I mean, it's fine to vent and everything, but you know, the team would come in, and then everybody would get all kissy kissy to them. And just let's address it with them and see how they react to it. I don't know. It was a very unfortunate thing, because it was really a special moment in time. I don't want to give too much credit to Blab. I think it was the community too. But whatever it was, some of the features, the way they welcome you, what you welcome people who are new to the platform, you could see everybody in the broadcast without having to scroll up away from the broadcast. You could easily connect to social. There were just so many different things that, you know, the platform had the record button, so you could have a pre-show and post-show, and people would be comfortable that you could just chat, and you didn't have to worry about that part being repurposed. So think about all these great, great features that it had. And I think for a short bit of time, it was the greatest social network ever created. Because when I look at what Facebook did at the end of the year, and they said, these are your 300 something friends that you made this year. Right. And I don't think they put all of them on that picture, but they put a lot of them on that picture. And I couldn't find one that I didn't meet as a result of Blab or live streaming. And if it wasn't for Blab, I wouldn't have done live streaming. So one way or another, Blab was the big connector to just about everybody on that picture. So it definitely had a big impact on us, even if we weren't happy with the way things wound down and ended.
Well, absolutely. And I think what you made that statement, it was the lie, because the lie was that we're not going anywhere. You know, we're not going in there. You know, we're just, everything's going to be fine. And so then I know I had, I think 38 shows already booked, because you know me, I'm like way in advance, right? I had 2-3 shows a week I was doing at the time, 38 shows, and then boom, they're gone, like gone. And when we brought Tony Robbins on the platform, you know, Anthony Conklin and I had Tony Robbins on there, we were afraid when he comes in what was going to be there. And so what we can determine from that, though, is that live streaming can be all it needs to be. That communities, people like you that are driving the intensity and the passion and saying, hey, here's the peeps that are delivering quality content. It doesn't mean there aren't others, but these people have a show. They're respectable. They are committed. They're focused. You know, this content is going to be there. They're not just kind of hit and miss, and they're not going to be probably in their negligee, or they're not going to be, you know, they're not going to be just rolling out of bed, that they actually are delivering value to the marketplace. And so you were able to share that.
I want to highlight a comment that Chris Barrow said, because he said, when you're a startup, you need to be flexible and be willing to bend. They weren't. And that's because they had an idea what they wanted it to be. They wanted it to be young. They wanted it to be this viral, generational thing. I don't even know what they meant by some of the terms that they used to describe it. And they should have looked around and said, hey, we've got something that's catching fire. We've got a passionate group of evangelists who were not paying anything and taking off. And you say, you know, the end result should be to get the most value for your investors and, you know, keep your employees employed and keep a company going and grow it and all that. And so if it ended up being a talk show platform and not a hangout platform, if it ended up being adults rather than teens or whatever, if it wasn't a generational platform and it just turned into a profitable platform, I think that could have been okay. But they were not open.
Right.
They did not care about the community that came, and they did not like the community that came, and it did not fit with their vision. Even though, as Chris also mentioned, they purposely went after podcasters in the beginning, and then they denied that at the end. Oh, that's not a use case. Well, you know, let's go to the videotape. I mean,
you told us to bring shows. You told us to do that. And then when we did it, then you didn't want it anymore. But yeah, so we can see that there's, I call that flip-flopping, right? There's a lot of flip-floppers in life and in business, and certainly in a live streaming platform, in radio, in TV. We know that there are people that do those flip-flopping things. And so, you know, we really want to teach people, you know, part of you have a business, you know, you're an entrepreneur, and live stream universe, I'd like you to tell people, you know, why you started it and what its purpose is, because you actually do also share with people how to build quality content, right? And what to do and how to do it. So why don't you tell us a little bit about that?
So I started Livestream Universe as a hobby. Like, I'm just going to show off what people are doing and other people. Like I said, I wasn't even going to get on camera. I'd never used a webcam before. I was just enjoying kind of being a part of it. But I think it's important when you do something to leave open the possibility. Like, Blab didn't leave open the possibility that it could grow into something that they hadn't expected, right? So even in choosing the name and in choosing a logo, in going about, even though it was sort of like, I'm not putting pressure on myself for this to become anything that brings in any revenue for a long time or whatever, I'm still going to kind of put the pieces in place so that if this thing takes off, what we'll let it become what it becomes, whether it becomes a place that covers the news about live streaming, whether it's a place that hosts broadcasts, whatever it does. And I found along the way, a lot of people have questions because many of the people come from social rather than from broadcasting. So how do you structure a broadcast? How do you promote it? How do you deliver information? How do you tease what's coming up? How do you recap what's happened before? How do you find, I think the big one for business owners is, how do you find that area that makes for a good talk show or a good conversation or an entertaining live stream and also connects to your business? Because your core business may or may not in and of itself be super broadcast friendly, right? If you're making widgets in a factory or whatever, there's only so much you can talk about how the machines run and the assembly line works and all that kind of stuff, right? But you can talk about the town where it's located, or you can talk about, you can find another way to frame it. And then when somebody needs a wit, like I always use the example of Mitch Jackson, right? He talks about tech. Yes, he talks about the law, but he talks about mostly about tech. He interviews interesting people. He's made himself known so that when someone actually is in California and needs a lawyer, they think, who do I know? Oh, Mitch Jackson is there, right? Yeah. So he touches on the law, and he lets you know that he's an attorney, just as you let people know that you do sales. But that doesn't mean that you have to discuss the mechanics of sales on every broadcast. Right. It's finding ways to entertain and inform and teach and communicate and laugh and joke. And then there's still a path that allows you, some people more directly than others, to bring people into your business. And like you said, the know, like, and trust, the time and relationship, and eventually, you know, people end up wanting to do business with you. So that's kind of what I like to help people with is, you know, there's those that help with the tech side. I understand social more than most people who come from the broadcasting side.
Right, but
so I can help them tie a social strategy around it, or a website, and digital marketing techniques and things like that. But it's more, okay, how are we going to do a broadcast that both interests an audience and connects them to you, and yet has some sort of tie to who you are and what you're doing, so that you can ultimately drive traffic to your website or your business or whatever. And that's not often an easy easy match to make, because as anybody who worked in radio knows, you could have a psychic on and that'll make the phones light up, right? But that doesn't necessarily mean that you're going anywhere with your show. Or you can do sports, you can talk about whether Pete Rose should be in the Hall of Fame, and oh my God, all the lines light up, right?
Right.
But that doesn't, first of all, how many lines light up doesn't mean how many people are listening, right? It just means that people want to talk about that. And it also doesn't mean that it has any momentum to the next day's show and the next day's show and what you're trying to do with your larger community.
Right. And that's certainly something that we as broadcasters, we have to, and not only dictate, but we have to, you know, kind of focus. And then like we have some, you know, of those phone calls coming in right now. Michael's in the house, Maya, Brad, Carlos are all here, you know, and it's funny because there, for those of you guys who have downloaded this podcast, I have to tell you that there are some great comments going on in the chat. And I would love for you guys to go to episode 29 with Mr. Ross Brand, again, on VickiFitch.com. Go to the Vicki Fitch Live page. But, you know, they're goofing around with each other. I have to tell you, it's becomes a community. And they're teasing Carlos. They're talking about Zeph and Carlos and stalkers. And there's a whole sub-community happening besides what's happening right here on the broadcast, because it's part of the community. And that's what we want you guys to understand, is that this is not, it's not just a broadcast, you know, that Ross and I are sitting here chatting. And one of the unique pieces of this going live here on Facebook Live is that we are having a live audience chat. I'm giggling sometimes of what's going on there, you know, if you didn't know these guys, you might wonder if some of that's inappropriate, but you know, it's just that kind of the way it goes. But it might also intrigue those of you who are listening only to the podcast to definitely jump into episode 29, maybe go check it out on YouTube and start, you know, seeing what's happening there, because again, communities are developing. When you're listening to a podcast or even a live radio show, you can't really connect with the audience, and you might be laughing out loud in your car or something, but no, you look around, nobody's there with you. But this, there's a community of people that are in this broadcast talking to each other and communicating with us at the same time. So it puts this whole new spin on what live broadcasting is. And that is where it's the beauty, right? It's the beauty.
Absolutely.
Of what we're doing and the relationships. Again, I'm cracking up at Carlos and Brad and there and the way they're you know, kind of goofing around. And Maya said, and hopefully I'm saying your name right, Maya, that this is great content. It's entertaining. It's informative. It's engaging. You're a handsome man, Ross. So people are getting to check you out. And that is a lovely thing as well. My niece Chloe is adorable. So that was really kind of fun too.
Oh, this is really so much fun. And I think what makes live streaming special and different from TV and different from radio, even though those mediums at this day and age will still net you a much, much larger audience. I mean, so many times larger, you can't even measure it, right? But I don't know that, and somebody else said this to me who's been doing podcasting and now live streaming and stuff. He doesn't think he could go back to doing shows without a live audience anymore. You just start to feed off of that energy and it focuses you. It's like I could do my updates when I record them, and sometimes I'll need to like start it a few times just to get my energy going and whatever. And I'm finding when I do them live, it focuses me to the point that I can just whip through it in one take. And even if I mess up, it's kind of fun because I'll joke around about it and then I'll get back to it. So I think this is what makes this special. And I think TV is going to try and find ways, and they haven't done it well up to this point, to incorporate the audience and bring comments in. You see it like a presidential debate. Let's go out to a question from Facebook. And you know, it's so, and it should be vetted in that kind of case,
right?
But it's the same question that could have been asked by anybody in person.
Sure.
Or you see the news shows like, let's read the tweets from the week. Uh-huh. That isn't really how Twitter works, right? It's an ongoing conversation. So reading tweets from Monday on Friday's show is right. I mean,
it's not exactly live and engaging.
right. And that's what this has. And that's why this is special. And it helps build community, because you're feeding off the comments. And when I'm interviewing somebody, there's always people in the chat who know more about the person, who know more about the subject. Mm-hmm. And so in addition to listening to the person and seeing where to go with the next question, mm-hmm. I'm also crowdsourcing by looking at the comments and seeing somebody's going to have a better question than I probably would have thought up. And let's bring that right in and acknowledge them. And that is so cool. Right. And that's something, you know, like we were saying before, in radio, you can take phone calls. Right. Sure. And that is about as close as it gets. But you're sitting in a room and you don't know who's listening and you don't know what's going on. You don't even know if the sun's shining outside when you're reading the weather. Right? I mean, for the most part. And hey, thanks for stopping in, Chris. Great to see you. Chris Barrows, by the way, does a great podcast. You got to check it out. YI Social, good friend of mine. And he's also NYU as well. So.
Maybe I might have to have Chris on the broadcast. We might
you
have
should,
to.
Have you should. You should. Chris is tremendous. Chris is tremendous. But that's kind of the thing. I mean, I think it's just so wonderful to be able to have those conversations. And I don't know if you do much with Instagram Live. I haven't done a lot with it. Uh-huh. But I love the fact that you can get on Instagram Live. It doesn't record. And you just can talk to people and you don't have to worry if there's dead air, if there's, you know, you don't have to promote it. You don't have to think about repurposing it. You don't have to, you can just communicate with people. So it's almost like all just engaging with the chat. And that's fun sometimes too. And it's there's all these different sides of live streaming now. And I'm having a blast with it.
Well, I have to tell you, I've done a couple Instagrams, but for me, I don't mm-hmm. see the same kind of value. I don't use that as a primary audience. So I don't have as many people there. So there's not as much interaction like there is on Periscope, for instance, which I can always delete that. But I like the fact, because I am a repurposer, that, right. you know, I'll take tweets, I'll take sections. I transcribe the podcast so we can, you know, use different parts of the content and stuff in other places so we can, you know, develop the even a broader audience. So I really do enjoy that. And by the way, for you guys that are here, I want to say one more time that the, you know, the Enlightened Audio Visual Production team is amazing. We can actually, as you saw, I brought in my niece, Chloe, we can have more people. We could literally, now we don't have the vetting process set up, but we literally could bring in people from here to come in live on screen and answer the question. So if you've thought about incorporating that into your own live streams, if you've thought about, you know, stepping up your live streaming game, I really encourage you to talk to Rob Hicks, Mr. Sam Gonzalez, and really start looking at it, because this is the next generation. This is where live streaming is going. And I'm going to be honest with you guys. There are ways to do some of this by yourself, but it's so much different. I get to sit here and connect with you, contact you, talk to Ross. I'm not sitting here doing, I can't say I'm not looking at any controls, but you know, I don't have to sit here and try and make sure the right thing's up. Hey, Wagner's in the house. What's hey, up, brother? Wagner. And Lindsay Badger is here. I miss those guys, you know. That there's an opportunity here for you to, again, step up your game. And if you wanted that, I'm not afraid of who the heck's coming in. You could have some wild and crazy stuff go on and you know, and launch into your own type of live streaming. But you know, just think about it, guys. Think about it. And those of you, again, who are listening on iTunes or Stitcher that you've downloaded this podcast, first of all, I want to say thank you. I really do appreciate you subscribing to my channel. I appreciate you listening. Hopefully you're laughing as you're listening. But I would love for you to connect. And I would love for you to see what's going on here behind the scenes. And honestly, I hope that you will follow some of those channels like YouTube and stuff so you can watch this broadcast later, youtube.com/VickiFitch. Ross's episode number 29 will be up there where you can check out what we're talking about. And you can actually, if you go to Facebook, you can see these comments that are scrolling in and what they actually mean and start to get to know some of the audience members as well. So, you know, I really, really do love that. I want to kind of move our stuff a little bit into talking about, you know, Summit Live. And, you know, Ross, the fact is that you're a speaker at Summit Live. And I think we have a coupon discount code that we are going to put up for you. If you guys are going to Summit Live here in California, you can definitely check that out. Ross is going to be one of the speakers there. And I kind of got asked to speak there myself today. So it's not official, but I it's semi-official. I don't know. I asked him. I said,
how fun is this going to be?
Right? Wouldn't that be cool? So it's unofficially official. So Ryan, if you're there, you know, you're going to either make it official or make me look like a fool. Either one, it's totally okay.
now he's got to go with it. It's like when I ask somebody on the show, so you're going to come back in a few months and do another one? What are they going to say? No, in front of everyone? No, that's really... But no, that was slick. But thank you for bringing that up. If you go to livestreamuniverse.com, there'll be a picture like the one that Vicki put up, and you just click that and enter the promo code Ross Brand and save 20% on tickets. So we really would love to see as many people from the community there as possible. It's going to be fun to speak, but really it's connecting with people that I've gotten to know and become friends with through live streaming to now meet them in person and hang out with them and, you know, explore opportunities to collaborate and be on each other's shows and all sorts of stuff. It's going to be a good time. So if you're thinking about going, head on over to Livestream Universe and just click that image and you can enter the promo code Ross Brand and save 20%.
Yeah. And saving money is always great, right? We all want to do that. And so, you know, as we talk about that, I also want to talk about one of the sponsors that's going to be there at Summit Live is Archon Mounts, which is also a sponsor here on the show. And so if you guys are going to get into live streaming, I highly recommend that you guys check out the Archon gear. You guys, if you watch me every day, you know, I dual stream on my TW broadcaster. I also use that little mount in the picture there. It is amazing. You can go to archon.com. That's ARKON.com. And if you use the code FITCHSLAP, and you guys know that's F as in Frank, ITCHSLAP, you get a 20% discount from them. They are amazing. Again, that is the gear that I use. That is the gear most of the live streamers I know, because it's rock solid. And Aaron at Archon Mounts is a huge advocate of the live streaming community. When you need something, you know, he makes adjustments and get it for your car, guys. Do not do distracted driving. Make sure that you have your phone mounted when you're using it as navigation, and do not live stream while you're driving. Can I just say that one more time? Don't. And hey, I see Sabrina Cadini in the house. Hey. Girl, how are you? It's so good to see you. Jen Nelson's here. Do we not have the most awesome people in the house? I mean, seriously.
It's really amazing. Yeah. It's wonderful.
Yes, Alfredo, Fitch Slap is my code. I have another podcast called He Said, Red Said, where red is always right. And somebody is going to get Fitch Slapped. And just for the record, because this is a G-rated show, what the Fitch Slap means, a Fitch Slap is a public service. It only comes out when necessary. It is always done in love, and it's used to redirect someone who's gone off course, just so you know. That's what a Fitch Slap is, and it's also a 20% discount for you. So,
love that.
And Stacey Lynn Harp's in the house. Hey, Stacey.
Hey, Stacey.
We have to share, right? We have to let them know that, you know, I'm a G-rated girl, so mm-hmm. I really did say Fitch. My last name's Fitch. It's Fitch Slap. And
right, and it's for their own good.
Let's face it, you saw some Fitch Slaps on Blab, because I had to take some of those boys down, right? Oh my gosh.
That's
fun. Okay, so Ross, talk to us about Summit Live. Talk to us about being a speaker. Have you been a speaker before? Or are you launching from the broadcasting industry into speaking, and do you plan on doing more of it?
Well, I've done speaking, at NYU and at other colleges, universities around New York, talking about social media, talking about HR, which I have a background in, and things like that. More smaller, you know, events, not something like Summit Live, where I imagine there'll be like thousands of people or whatever, lots of media. So I'm excited for this, but we'll see where it goes. I'm going to do CreatorCon Live also in late April. But like I say, I'm excited about connecting with people, and the panel is going to be all about monetizing your live stream, directly monetizing. So I think everybody's going to want to learn a little bit about that. Right.
Right. Exactly.
So, I was communicating with Sabrina earlier, who's the event manager, and she said maybe by the end of the week, they'll announce who's going to be on the panel. So I'm looking forward to seeing who I'll be working with, and, you know, the questions that start developing some questions and doing a little research on it. But it's a great topic, right? Who doesn't want to monetize something if they can? So
right.
People are doing it, and it's a great opportunity to learn from those who are, you know, kind of pioneering that path to making money from their live video.
Well, we will probably be doing something together then, because I'm speaking at a CreatorCon too on, it was on the $50,000. I had done $50,000 in 5 months that I had done a broadcast, and I had been on a few radio shows and stuff. But I had like an announcement I made earlier that I did over 50,000 in the last 3 weeks. On because of live streaming. And so, you know, I think what we're trying to do is really help people understand that when you do build a platform that, again, right, like you're talking about, Ross, where we build value, where we're identifying, you know, that there's content here. It's not us rolling out of bed and, you know, people are actually doing bed scopes and, you know, whatever, the, you know, they're doing this crazy stuff. And then they come on the next day as this, like, as a business coach. And I'm like, well, I think I saw your lingerie last night, and I certainly know what your bedroom looks like. I'm thinking that this is a little TMI for the business, you know. I don't really want to know that you have a hot pink teddy. I just don't want to know.
where is that broadcast?
Yeah, I'm sorry, I'll send you the links later. And Sabrina, yes, I will be at Summit Live as well, and but thank you for asking. But you know, it's really cool, Ross, that we, again, come as this piece, right? And we get to deliver content because we want to help people
right.
take this to the next level, not to just, you know, not to just be okay if they want to monetize, to just be okay with not being able to figure it out and then just giving up on it and saying, well, I'm not going to live stream, or I'm not going to try and earn money. Because they get, it's that defense mechanism. They want to start, you know, putting up that shield that says something's wrong with me if I haven't been able to, when other right. people can. So delivering that value is awesome.
And what I like is that, you know, when I worked in broadcasting, I obviously evaluated a lot of talent. I screened tapes, you know, back then we had resume tape, and then it went right. to CD and whatever, right? So, you know, you would start to get a feel for somebody within seconds of like popping it in, whether they were barking up the right tree or not, right?
Exactly.
So I can see the talent in a lot of the people who are doing live streaming, and it's kind of fun to watch over time as they develop and they get better. I mean, as wonderful as Blab was for allowing us to create the community, mm-hmm. it was a mediocre broadcast platform, right? The technology worked sometimes, it didn't. You would be Gilberting all day, right. For those who know that. I believe it's now in the dictionary, right?
Right, I think it is.
And so while the other platforms haven't necessarily given you a built-in community, there are better broadcast platforms. And I think those that have stuck with it after Blab, such as yourself and many of the people who are watching right now, I see them in the chat and have stuck with it on other platforms, have used the opportunity really to kind of raise their game and get better at what they're doing, because now the pressure's on you to bring an audience.
Right.
Or in Blab, you had a built-in audience that would right. just find you and jump in the room. And, you know, you could pull people right in so easily. It's not as easy on other platforms to bring in people and get them there. So now it's kind of about, like, your broadcast really does have to connect to a community. And then it doesn't really matter which platform comes or goes, because you have people who know you and like you and are gonna show up. And so I think, if there's something good that came out of Blab's demise, it's that those who have really committed themselves to sticking with live streaming, I've seen them really develop as broadcasters sure. and as content creators due to necessity, right? Sometimes a adversity or a challenge pushes you to get better. And that's what I'm kind of excited about going forward, is seeing as these platforms continue to develop and continue to change, and some continue to disappear, right? Because like Huzzah just went off the right? playing field, right? It's not a, but people who will stick with it will get better, right?
Right.
You know, Huzzah had its limitations too, and they'll probably find a platform that's better, or they'll learn a new way to broadcast, or they'll learn a new way to use technology, or they'll collaborate with other people. And, you know, the end result for those that stick with it, I guarantee it'll be better than what they were doing before they got that rug pulled out from under their feet, right?
Absolutely. And I see Mr. Nick Rishwain is here, and Nick has a lot of great things to say there too. And again, what another great contributor to the community. We have just some fabulous people. And so since we're talking about building community, we would love for you guys to click that little share button. Now, again, only if you're finding value here. If you're not finding value, we are not asking you to, you know, to push out content that you think is mediocre at best, because really we're trying to step up the bar. And
this isn't mediocre.
If we are not mediocre, hashtag not mediocre. It's just, we want to make sure if you guys are finding value, please share it out. Again, Ross is such a great guest. He's going to actually, he doesn't know it yet, but we're going to have him give a few of his tips that, you know, whether it's his live streaming tips, whether it's broadcasting tips, you know, I'd love for you to throw some out there at the people that are here, because they want to know, they want to glean from you, Ross, and you have so much experience and expertise. What would be your top tips on any of those categories? You know, what do you want to deliver to the audience?
My top tip, the most important interviewing skill is listening. The best questions, the best next question comes not from what's on your script, but comes from something that the person you're interviewing said, which allows you to either drill down more or move on to something else. Or, you know, it just, that's where the great ideas, because something will come up that either you weren't aware of or opens the opportunity to go further. So listen. I know we'd love to engage in the chat while the guest is talking, and you shouldn't ignore the chat by any stretch. But the first priority is the conversation, because that's what everybody is listening to and watching. And so if you miss a few comments or whatever, but you're able to listen and get information that you can then use to ask a better question or continue a better conversation than otherwise, focus on listening. The second tip I would give is that audio is more important than video, which sounds kind of weird because it's a video medium. But if the video went out and we continued talking, people could still follow this. But if the audio went out, even as beautiful as we all are here, right? it would get old kind of fast just watching our So if you have a choice between getting a fancy camera or getting a microphone or a headset or something that allows your voice to project in a clear fashion and makes it easy to listen to, that's more important than how you look or the lighting or whatever. And I'm not saying that you should have an empty background like this. I've got a ways to go. I'm new to the whole video aspect, but it's not just a bias coming from radio. I think you'll find a lot of TV people will say audio has got to be the priority, particularly for a talk show, right? Because you can put this on, you can go in another browser and you can check your email, you can do work, all that kind of stuff, and you can still listen. But if you can't listen, it doesn't matter how great the picture is. There's nothing really to consider. Right.
It's totally true, especially since this is also a podcast, right, where people are downloading. So, but you know, it's funny you say that, because, you know, Periscope used to have glitches, and I happen to be a Team Android participant. I know there's Team Apple. We used to have these fun debates on Periscope all the time, because I was on Periscope, I think the second or third day it came out, but I had with a friend's phone, because I don't have an iPhone. So we had to wait. So as of the day it came out for Android, I've been on. But it would, every time they do updates, all of a sudden things wouldn't work. So I used to do what I called a radioscope, because there was no picture, but people could hear it. And so I would hashtag it radioscope until they updated the software. And so, like you said, people would still come on. They couldn't see me, but I could see their chat and we would talk. And it still was another way to build community, instead of making excuses and saying, I can't do it, I can't keep up my live stream or whatever, you know. Professionals, they trudge on. And again, that was, I think, a really, really great tip. And Marissa said it's a great point, you know, that she can go and, you know, listening to a podcast. And she also said that, you know, you're speaking from a true broadcaster. So she really appreciates who you are.
So is there another area, like, I don't have another tip off the top of my head I can think of, like, what would you... Is there some area you'd like me to talk about?
I think that was gold right there. And I hope people listen to it. And I know Nikki's going to pull that one out, is that, you know, your tip is listen, is that, you know, because again, here, I always say, if nobody's watching and nobody's listening, I don't care. Now, this is tongue in cheek. I don't mean that literally to the audience, but my job is to connect with you, you know, my guest. And have you been on a broadcast before where the person interviewing you wasn't paying attention and they are looking at comments and then you're done speaking and you can tell they're not even like mentally with you and you're trying to figure out, should I keep talking or, you know, and then you stop and then, you know, you're kind of waiting.
Well, the best, and you see this happen on major news networks with personalities who are making millions of dollars a year, right? And they'll ask a question and the question will be answered, like what the next question would be was answered with the first question. And they'll ask that same, they'll ask that question anyway. And the person will be like, well, as I just said, you know, so how is it that you're being fed the questions, right? You have nothing to do but look and listen, right? There's no audience to engage, there's no chat, and yet you don't listen well enough that or look ahead at the next question. Okay, anyway.
It's pathetic is what it is. And so we're not trying to diss you guys, but you might want to check out Ross's, you know, he's got a course and stuff coming out or whatever. You might want to keep watching Mr. Ross Brand so you guys can learn how to even be better at your game. Because like you said, and that doesn't make as a guest, it doesn't make me feel valued. It makes me feel like I'm carrying the show because I don't want to leave them hanging and I'm a professional. And so it doesn't make me feel valued when they're typing or they're doing something and, you know, I'm talking, not saying we don't sometimes behind the scenes have something to do or, you know, might have an audio issue or something going on, but we know what we're talking about is that we want to feel like the person interviewing us actually cares about who we are and what we have to say and not just, they just want us to, you know, be a talking head.
And I think what's great now is with the ability to that we can do now to switch shots, like Rob is switching shots. He'll switch to a full screen of you. He'll switch to a full screen of me. He'll switch to the two shot. And you can do that with Be Live TV. You can do that with Wirecast and OBS if you produce yourself. And that gives me an ability to take a drink of water when you're on. It gives me ability to quickly look at some comments on my phone. Sure. And of course, it's great in this setup, which, you know, I don't think I've really seen before that the comments, I hope you don't mind me revealing behind the scenes, but the comments actually come up within a window here in Zoom behind the scenes. And that allows me also to be looking at you and listening to you and then just glancing down at the comments and being able to stay on top of things. And I see, you know, Alfredo dropping my Livestream Universe bio in, which is so cool. And I don't have to pick up a cell phone and look away from you to know that that's going on. So I think, you know, as technology and as your options for having your broadcast produce increase, I think there's going to be more ways that we can stay on top of the chat, but not lose the flow of the conversation. And like I was saying earlier, the conversation is the first priority because while you may miss a comment or you may miss acknowledging somebody, if you focus on the conversation, then you're delivering value to everybody. And then you gradually learn to bring in comments and questions and take that extra special area of live streaming that makes it unique and different from TV or radio.
Definitely. And like you said, that's Mr. Sam Gonzalez that does that. He is, you know, he steps up and does a rocking job to make it easier for us. So we do get to keep our eyes, you know, engaged with each other. And Rob tries to make sure if there's something we miss because, you know, you're talking or we're in the middle of a point, that he tries to make sure that we see it. Because again, this is what it's about. This is what connection and caring, when people actually care what's happening and it's not just, let me see what I can do for ratings or whatever, you know, it's, this is about, you know,
we get ratings on this.
Hey,
I got to check the ratings.
You know, I have to tell you on two of my broadcasts, I'm really proud of this. So I'm going to share it. And I see, Mr. Aaron Roth is in the house. We just talked about the promo code there, fitchslap@archon.com. Just so you know, Aaron, we're on it. We're sharing the live streaming gear with the peeps here.
But, and Aaron's going to be on Livestream Stars, if you don't mind me giving a quick shout out. He's going to be the first guest in March. So I'm looking forward to, and we're going to meet him at Summit Live.
Absolutely.
So I can't wait to do that as well.
Yes, absolutely. We do love Aaron, Sabrina, and Aaron. Yes, we put that up. Remember the code Fitch Slap. And, you know, if you guys come to Summit Live, I will give Aaron a Fitch Slap in person. Just so you guys know, it'll happen. If you guys didn't see me when I was down at the
on stage
live streaming. Yeah, totally.
In front of everybody.
So we have to make sure. Okay, this is, don't tell him, but make sure the security guards move, because I'm going to totally come straight down the aisle while he's up there and slam. That'll be classic, right? Because I know people will live stream it. And
That's awesome.
Aaron is such a good sport too. He would totally go with it, right? Did you Fitch Slap Ross? No, I was saving it for you, Aaron. Because
that's,
you
know, great. That's right? A good idea. Yeah, I agree with that.
Yeah, because we don't want to take Ross down. Ross is really nice. Kidding, Aaron. We love you too. For those of you guys who have downloaded this on iTunes and Stitcher, I really do hope that you guys will check out the live video of episode 29 with Mr. Ross Brand of Livestream Universe. I hope you guys will attend Summit Live in LA. Go to summit.live.com, or actually go to livestreamuniverse.com. Click that link and you can save 20% on your ticket. I'd love to meet you guys there. If you're going, definitely send me a message. Tweet me on Twitter at Vicki_Fitch, and let's have a meetup. I would love to connect with people that are going. Why are the yeah, that's right. Aaron wants to know why he's the only one that's giving us hearts. We want some hearts, peeps. Tap, tap, tap those things away and share out the broadcast if you haven't already. So again, come watch the live ones on YouTube, on VickiFitch.com, and Ross might even throw something up on Livestream Universe when we send him the files.
Absolutely. But,
you know, Ross, you know, there's so much more we could say. We have about 12 minutes left of the broadcast, and I want to know, you know, I want to know a lot about you, which I didn't get much chance, but we did get a chance to see who you are because we talked about the blab. We talked about, right, you know, kind of transitioning, and we got to interact with the audience. You know, what are your hopes and aspirations? Like, where do you see yourself going, and what are your dreams? What do you want to do with live streaming? What do you want to do with your business? You know, tell us so maybe we can become part of your, you know, your dream builders and help you with those dreams.
Yeah. I mean, I just want to see and help people who have some talent for live streaming, know why they want to do it, are interested in connecting and providing, you know, good information, useful information, valuable content within a sense of community. And it's fine. I want them to monetize it. I want them to succeed at it. And if I can help people become better at the broadcasting side of it and how to integrate that with social and their equipment and things like that. I just love seeing people who are new to broadcasting, and some of them don't even know how good they are at live streaming. Did you do any broadcasting before this? Were you, you're really good at this. See, I would have thought you were a broadcaster. No. You're a natural. You never let the ball drop when you're talking. So I seriously, I really enjoy that. And I mean that sincerely, Vicki. And I really enjoy seeing people who are new to it and have a knack for it. And then looking at how can they take it to the next level? And could they get a TV show or get TV appearances, or could they do radio, or, you know, could they get a live stream show that's sponsored or produced, you know, and what is the next kind of path for them? So, you know, people have questions about how they can develop their game as a live streamer and how to tie their content to their business and how to develop their broadcasting skills so that they can move to the next level or get sponsored or work with brands or, you know, whatever it is that they want to do to do more than just providing sort of freemium content, as so many people are, right? Mm-hmm. I'm happy to work with people like that and help them develop, and I really love seeing the development that some people have had. And I don't know if she's watching now, but she was on earlier. I'm so excited that Leslie Nance was nominated for Periscoper of the Year for the Shorty Awards. I mean, she's just somebody who got on, fell in love with doing what she's doing, has a great message, has a unique area that she works in, and helping people, you know, make their bodies inhospitable to cancer and keep their health up and make their own health decisions and turn their kitchens into a place that supports that, right? And she's gotten to a point where she's just doing tremendous stuff, and it's being recognized. She's going to speak at Summit Live, Periscoper of the Year. So there's somebody that just has shown up every day and kept working at it, and she's built a great community, And I'm so excited. She's been a regular part of the updates, which I love. You know, she's been a regular part of the live stream updates. Probably since the summer. She's been on Livestream Stars. She's always been super, super community oriented and everything. So I'm really proud about what she's doing coming out of this kind of community. She wasn't a regular on Blab, but she had been interviewed on Blab and did some stuff on Blab. And so I'm really happy to see that she's getting that recognition. And I Livestream Universe wholeheartedly endorses her in the election for Periscoper of the Year. And you can vote for her. Vote go2kitchens.com. Go to the number 2 kitchens.com. Fantastic.
Well, you know, I can say I don't actually really know her, so I'd love an introduction. And you know, if you're saying that she's great, I'm sure she is absolutely fantastic. And by the way, the heart to you for saying such nice things about me, I really appreciate it. I definitely love the opportunity to connect with people, and especially, you know, people like you who are, again, delivering value and content. And so if you guys do know anybody that's looking for a new TV show host, I'm in. I'm just saying, I think I could totally rock. I was telling one of the audiences, I think I could totally rock like the Tonight Show. Like, we'll just ignore the audience and I'll just get right in there on that couch and talk to them.
I could see you like as the anchor of a morning show or something, right? Where you're on the couch with like another anchor or whatever, and you have these celebrities come in and you have newsmakers come in and absolutely. You cover like the big news stories of the day, but then you do fun stuff, you do business advice, all sorts of. So yeah, check out in LA if then the morning person there isn't doing a very good job, maybe
just need to pop her out, say I'm sorry, give a little Ross says I'm in,
a little Fitch slap and take over the couch. I'm
in. Am I allowed to say that out loud, Rob? Am I allowed to say that out loud? Well, Rob just sent a message, which I know he'd put in a good word for me, that SAP was just looking for TV hosts today. So you guys, if you know Ursula and you know the people at SAP, you tell them Vicki Fitch is the girl for them. Can I start a campaign right now? Whoop, whoop. Well, you know, when you get to know,
you're supposed to put your application in first, then wait a couple of days and then announce it.
But that's not my style, Rob.
No, I know. I'm
right in there, right?
And you know, you got the skills. Go ahead. Go ahead.
I mean, come on now.
Bring it on.
Oh, I love it. And Sabrina says they need me. I love you, Sabrina. I love you. You're awesome. So again, that's part of community, right? Is that we can kind of, you know, we can throw stuff out there. We can just say, hey, you know what? When we can help other people to reach their dreams, like we want to help Ross to reach as many people as he can. I hope you guys shared this broadcast out. And again, if you're finding value, but Ross, anything that I can do to help you to build on your dreams, I'm in, because I think, I think you're a stellar guy. And I really love the way you've embraced the community and you're always giving. I mean, you are the giver, you know, I mean, I honestly, you're amazing.
Well, thank you so much. I really appreciate it. And it's been a while, right? We've been working on doing this for like 8 months or something, I'm so glad that I came on today and we were able to do this. And it's just been such a blast talking with you. I think I've been smiling the whole time, and that isn't always the case. Just my natural demeanor is to sit and listen and whatever. So I've had a blast, and I can't wait to meet you in person and talk more and see your speech at Summit Live and find other opportunities to collaborate as we move forward with this live streaming journey.
Absolutely. I mean, honestly, I think it's going to be great. And I see Amir's in the house. And by the way, I want to give a special shout out to Nikki Ramos, if she's still here. Nikki is my right hand. Nikki is the bomb.com. I just want that on the record that Nikki, you are amazing. You make my life so much easier, and I just want you to know that I truly, truly appreciate you. So you rock that dream every day, girl, and you make my life easy. So thank you to Nikki. And, you know, as we're, you know, going through the, you know, the last kind of wrap up stuff here, Ross, where is your favorite place for people to connect with you? I mean, we all have favorite social media platforms. What is yours, and what's the best way to reach you?
Well, looking at the chat, I can tell that I am connected on Facebook with most people, chat right now. I don't know, over the last year or so, like Facebook Messenger has become probably my most commonly used communication platform. So if we're connected on Facebook, send me a message through Facebook Messenger. If we're not connected, connect or head on over to the Livestream Universe Facebook page, facebook.com/livestreamuniverse, or just go to rossbrand.live. Like the page and send me a message, and we will continue the conversation over there. That was a shameless plug, right?
No, I'm sorry. I'm back here laughing because this is again where the comments come in. Amir wrote Tinder, the question mark. And that is why I started cracking up. See, once in a while, the comments really bring a new element to the show. And so,
where can people reach me? Just swipe right.
I'm sorry. I saw that and I burst into laughter. So again, hey, Aaron, stop dissing Messenger. I got to tell you, I have a whole series, just so you guys know, coming out on Messenger and how to use it to rock your rock.
If I could only communicate by Messenger, I would drop every other.
Right? Oh,
I love it. It's so easy. Everybody's right there. You just type in the first couple of letters. They come up.
Oh, and you guys, if you don't know, my dear friend Joel Kahn is in the house. Joel, these are for you, baby. If you guys, those of you on iTunes and Stitcher, remember, these are my hard eyes. They are only for Mr. Joel Kahn. He is a dear friend. He's been a guest on the show numerous times, and we totally appreciate you, Joel. Thanks for popping in and dissing us with the comment, wow, they let anyone use this. Okay, thank you so much for truly appreciating who we are. You know, Ross, I think somebody just Fitch slapped us, Ross. I think Joel. I think the chat, you know, Joel. I used to call Joel Kahn the blabjacker, right? Because he came into my show. It was He Said Red Said show, and he completely blabjacked the show. I created the term blabjacker because of him. He had me looking up when his first book came out on my own show, right? Yeah, but I loved it. And it was just an amazing opportunity. And again, shows you the relationships that we build, you know, around people that come in and be, and then they're themselves on live stream.
And Joel just attracts a following wherever he, I swear to God, he could go into a platform that nobody's ever used.
It's the Joel Kahn set. No, I'm just kidding.
Nobody's ever used. There'll be like 300 people sharing it out going, hey, Joel's trying this out. Everybody just goes in, see what he thinks of it and how he's using it.
If you've seen his hot new haircut and his new glass, man, the dude is smoking hot these days, and he's going to be speaking at Summit Live from what I hear. So ladies, if you don't have your ticket, remember, go to livestreamuniverse.com and get yourself a ticket and come check out Mr. Joel Kahn. He's a riot.
Just swipe right to connect with
Joel's on Tinder too. Joel and Ross are both on Tinder.
Hey, speaking of dating and relationships, how about this for a transition?
Okay, let's see.
Hillary Silver is my guest tomorrow night on Ask the Expert at 7 p.m. Eastern at Ross Brand Live.
Another Ross Brand shameless plug. I absolutely love it.
We'll be talking about with Valentine's Day coming up. We're not going to talk about live streaming or social media or business. We're going to talk about love, sex, and relationships with Hillary Silver. So
I'm blushing. Like, oh my goodness, I'm blushing. No, I think that's wonderful, Ross. Oh my gosh, Ross, this has been an absolutely phenomenal show. I appreciate you guys. If I missed any comments, guys, as we do the wrap up, throw them back in the chat box so I can ask Ross. But again, Ross, you dropped knowledge bombs here. You gave people a chance to see that lovely smile, the opportunity to see your personality, and again, to just give them a chance to see that you are truly a stellar person, that you've brought the community together. You continue to deliver value. We can't wait to see you speak at, I can't wait to speak with you at Summit Live. I can't wait to speak with you at CreatorCon. I'm sure there's other places.
So you're coming to New Jersey for CreatorCon?
I am. Yes.
Wow. Yes. Wow. I can't wait. That's going to be fun too.
It is, right? I know. I'm going right from ICON in Arizona to CreatorCon. So it's like,
awesome. Yeah, the Vicki Fitch World Tour.
I'm going to New Zealand in September to speak too.
That is a rock star,
right? Because you guys know I've been dying to go to Australia and New Zealand, and I have a mission this year. If we're talking about dreams, to speak in 6 international countries that I haven't been in yet. And so, if you guys, by the way, for those of you guys who don't know, and Claudia Santiago in the house, hola,
hey, Claudia. Hola,
¿cómo estás? That I have a goal to do 6 international speaking engagements for places I haven't been before. And I actually have up to a $500 referral fee for anybody that's referring me in for a fully paid speaking engagement. So you guys connect with me at VickiFitch.com/Vicki Media and Speaking. Connect with me there. So, and Joey's in the house. How are you? It's so good to see you, sweetheart. We are so glad to see you here. You know, Joey Giggles is here and he's always a riot and a sweetheart. And when we love his contribution as well. So really quick, I want to remind you guys that next week I have on Vicki Fitch Live, A Fresh Perspective. I have the super amazing luxury travel blogger, Ms. Mia Voss. Not only is Mia beautiful, funny, smart. Okay, she's freaking hysterical. That's what she is. And she is going to totally rock it. So I hope you guys will join us next Wednesday night with Miss Mia Voss. So Mia on the go. She is going to rock your world. And I've got to tell you, I'm really jelly. Hashtag jelly, because she gets to go to some super cool places. I told her I could be her fashionista, that I could just come along and pick out her handbags and her jewelry and stuff. You know, I could just totally do that. So, you know, so I'm really excited about that. And you guys know that I am still on my other podcast, He Said, Red Said, I'm still on the hunt for he. We're having some trouble with communicating with some people, but I would love, if you guys are interested, if you think that you could be a good radio broadcaster, if you guys are into some witty banter and you think you can take a Fitch slap and you can remember that Red is always right, then I'd love for you to go to HeSaidRedSaid.com. Yeah, Ross is laughing. No laughing there. That is
Red is always right.
If you guys go to Vicki, or he said redsaid.com, I'd love for you to fill out an application and let me know that you're interested so we can do some on-air interviews and see how well that goes. But again, appreciate you guys. And Ross, do you have any final words? We have like 2 minutes left. Do you have final words before we do your outro and show them your social media cards so they'll know all the ways to get in touch with you?
I just want to thank you for having me on. This was so much fun. And we'll continue the conversation at Summit Live, CreatorCon Live, and on Livestream Stars as well. We got to have you on, and then I can ask you about your story and put you on the hot seat. Ask you for some sales and broadcasting tips and different things. So I look forward to collaborating with you as we move along this year. It's been a lot of fun on the show.
Well, that would be awesome. And just for the record, I didn't pin him into that request to be on his show. He said that on his own. I may have, he accused me earlier of what I did with Ryan, but I didn't do that with Ross. I just want that on the record. So, oh my gosh. So again, you guys, you're so.
No, I was doing that with you. Now you have to come on.
I see.
But I did it very gently. But
I would love to come on. You know, I would absolutely love to be there. And, you know, love to give as much value as I can for sure.
Awesome.
You know, we're going to put Ross's information up here, and I'm going to introduce myself to those of you who aren't familiar with me in just a second, but please take a screenshot of that so you can connect with Ross Brandon. Don't forget livestreamuniverse.com. Click the link so you can get a ticket to Summit Live. Come meet myself. Come meet Ross. Let's connect. And you get a 20% discount just by clicking his link. So again, it's super exciting. And guys, I want to introduce myself for those of you again, who downloaded the podcast. Appreciate you being here. Thanks for subscribing. I hope you'll connect with me at VickiFitch.com. I also hope that you guys will check out my YouTube channel, as we're talking about. I'm trying to up my YouTube game over there. But my name is Vicki Fitch, guys. I'm a direct sales expert. I've been in the industry 20 years, top 10 sales and recruiting internationally for more than a decade. I've also built and sold 4 successful companies. I'm an author, a speaker, and an international business consultant, helping you get outside the 5,000 to turn your passion into your profits. If you want a free consultation, go to VickiFitch.com/20. That's VickiFitch.com/20. I'd love to give you a free 20-minute consultation on how I can help you to rock that dream. So guys, I know that you had, another great event here with Mr. Ross Brand, and I hope that you'll continue to follow. I hope you guys will participate in what's happening. And I do live stream every day, typically at 6 o'clock at night on both Periscope and Facebook Live. So let's stay connected. And until next time, I want to remind you, like I always do, to dream it, believe it, and achieve it. Ciao.